Einstein photoelectric equation. So this is a very important 3-mark question. So repeatedly asked question. So dear students, very simple. Already in the previous video detailedly explained the photoelectric emission. So photoelectric effect. So H nu is the incident light radiation energy. So when the high energetic incident light radiation falls on the photosensitive material, there is a few amount of energy is spent to remove the electron from the metal surface. That minimum energy required to remove the electron from the metal surface is called work function. Then the remaining part of the incident radiations will be taken by the electron as for spent for the kinetic energy of electron for the motion of the free electron through the wire. That flow of photo electrons through the wire is called photo current. So H nu is equal to work function plus kinetic energy of the electron is called photoelectric equation. So we know that the work function is equal to H nu naught is a, what is a nu naught? This is a threshold frequency. So what is threshold frequency? The minimum frequency required to remove the electron from the metal surface is called threshold frequency. That is the work function. So H into nu is the energy. So work is equal to energy. So work function is equal to H nu naught. So in the place of work function, we can substitute H nu naught. H is a Planck's constant, nu naught is a threshold frequency plus kinetic energy of the electron. Then you bring this one, this is a H nu, H into nu minus nu naught is equal to half mv squared, that is a kinetic energy of electron. So these are all the Einstein photoelectric equations. Then in the place of kinetic energy, we can substitute that EV naught, where V naught is called stopping potential. So what is the stopping potential? Even though the incident radiation is greater than the threshold frequency, the metal surface may be a photosensitive material, the photoelectric emission will happen. If the applied voltage is reverse, there will be a reverse potential. The minimum reverse potential required to stop the photoelectric emission is called stopping potential. So that will be equal to kinetic energy of the electron emitted, that is the photoelectron emitted. So EV naught. So in the place of kinetic energy, we can substitute EV naught. So that is a H nu naught is a work function. H nu is equal to work function plus EV naught. So I will bring the work function in the left side, that is a minus work function. Then bring the E in the denominator, work stopping potential, which is equal to H by E. So this E will be comes to the denominator, H by E into nu. Nu is incident frequency radiation minus W into this E will comes to the denominator, means work function by E. So this is equal to, this is equivalent to the straight line equation y is equal to mx plus c. So the for the straight line, if you draw the graph between the stopping potential and the incident frequency, that means x and y. So the graph between the x and y, that is the stopping potential and the frequency, is like this. So this slope must be equal to m, because this is a m is equivalent to h by e. So slope is equal to h by e. Then c is a intercept, that is equal to minus w by e, where w is a work function. So c is a intercept minus w by e. So the slope of this line is equal to m, that m is equal to Planck's constant by the charge of the electron. Then this intercept must be equal to minus of work function by charge of the electron. So where slope, which is equal to slope, which is equal to m is equal to h by e, where h is equal to slope into e. By this way, we can determine the Planck's constant experimentally. So determination of Planck's constant by using the photoelectric equation may be done. So the determination of Planck's constant and work function also we can calculate by using this formula, because this work function is equal to E into the magnitude of the intercept. So magnitude of the intercept, because C is equal to work function by E. If you bring this E this side, we get the work function. So we can calculate the work function, Planck's constant, by drawing the, by plotting the graph between stopping potential and the incident frequency radiation. So if the frequency increases, what about the change in all those things? We can study it and draw the graph. So this is photoelectric equation and the determination of Planck's constant and work function by using photoelectric equation, by drawing the graph between stopping potential and the incident frequency of light.